This conference will now be recorded.
Sir, what is an assertion? What is the use of the assertion? Sir, whenever application is implemented, who will implement the application? Developer. Immediately, he will use this application to the test engineer for the testing purpose. Sir, at the time of test engineer, at the checking of application, he will identify the defect. So what is a defect means? Something goes wrong in the application. Some expected result, actual result is not matches. That is called as a defect. Sir, whenever testing identify defect, immediately he will intimate it to the developer. Immediately he will intimate it to the developer about that defect. Now, what he will do is work is, what is the reason for defect? Why application is not working? Because of something mistakes in the program. So what to do now? He is performing on technique that is debugging. What it is? Debugging. Because of what is the bug in the application? Why application not working? Because of something code is wrong. Something coding, because test engineer identified defect, immediately intimated to the developer. Developer is accepted, okay, something goes wrong in application, but what is the problem? Okay, something wrong in the coding. Maybe logical errors, maybe syntax error, something problem is there. So in my program, how to identify those errors? Immediately developer using one technique, common technique, that is debugging. For suppose, tomorrow if you have written any program, sir, in your program, everything is perfect, but output is not coming properly. Then what to do? Everyone using debugging only. Generally, debugging means step-by-step execution to identify root cause for an error. That is called as a debugging. Previously sessions, we discussed about log files. What is the main log file? At the time of debugging, those files are usable. So, at the time of debugging, common way, everyone using one statement. Which statement we are using? Print statement. Suppose, sir, there are some program is there, some lines of the program. I'm using print statement. Sir, if it is executed, means this block is perfect, no problem. Again, after some of the commands, I'm using again one more print statement. If this one is also running, yes, now it is also perfect. Next day again I am writing some lines of the code. So like that, common way at the time of debugging is print statement only, because if the print statement is printing, yes, this block perfect. If it is printing, this block perfect. If here it is not printed, here it is not printed, then okay, something goes wrong in this block. Like that, common way of identifying bug fixing method is print. But what is the problem with this print means? Sir, once I resolve my defects, bugs, compulsory, before releasing code to the client, you have to remove all your print statements. Compulsory. Sir, why you are using print statement? For your understanding purpose, for your debugging purpose, you are using print statement. You can give the code with along print statement. Then at the time of runtime execution time, these print statements will be printed. Output is not coming properly. It will disturb your output too. So compulsory, your responsibility, remove all the print statements and hand over the code to the client. That is the process. But in this procedure, the main problem is why we are using that print statements. Instead of print statement, latest technology in the Python, everyone using assertion. Assert is a one keyword. So in the keyword list, assert is available there. Whenever I'm using assert keyword, then you get 100 assert keywords, no problem. At the time of giving client, just we are disabling, I am not removing. Because of print statement means, it will be printed, sir. Pakka, it will be printed in the console. Assets will be disabled. That too, the main advantage of asset is, sir, if something goes wrong, then all asset will be activated. If everything perfect, asset won't activate it. It won't disturb your code. It won't disturb your output. That is the main use of this asset. No upset. The purpose of identifying and fixing the bugs is called as a debugging technique. There, we are identifying the bugs and we need to fix that bugs. That is what is a debugging. So in the debugging, very common way, everyone using. Very common way of debugging. To use print statements commonly. Yes. After print statements, I got the solution, I can resolve. But the problem with this print statement is, after fixing your bugs, compulsory you have to remove that. Added print statements. If you are not deleted, these will be executed at runtime. Which creates performance problem. And it will disturb console output. That is the problem with that print statement. Because of, so print is useful at the time of debugging, but after fixing your bugs, compulsory you have to remove that print statement, sir. Otherwise, it will be disturbed your output and the console output will be disturbed. To overcome this problem, Python is supported asset statement. That is the reason we are using as a asset statement. So here, what is the main advantage? The main advantage of asset statement over print is, after fixing the bugs, you are not required to delete. Asset statements. That is the main advantage. Based on our requirement, we can enable or disable asset statement. So that is over the print statement and asset statement. Print compulsory, you have to remove that print. Asset, if you are not deleted, no issue. If you want to enable or if you want to disable, you can use your wish. So finally, conclusion. Hence, the main purpose of assertions to perform debugging. Usually, where we are performing this debugging, we can perform debugging either in development or in test environment. So at the time of why testing means, at the time of testing Selenium with Java, Python, we are writing some programs. Suppose my program is not working, what to do? We have to debug only. So development team, they are debugging, testing also debugging, but not in production. The production means live environment. So for every project, sir, different environments are there. Development environment, test environment, UAT, and production. Four environments are there for every project. Only debugging will be done at the time of development and testing. Applicable for development and test environment, but not for production. So that is the concept of our assertion. So in this assertion, how many types of assertions are available there? How many types? So there are two types of assert statements are there. There are two types of assert statements. So one I will tell, second one anyone guess it. One is simple assertion. So what is the second one? One simple assertion, second complicated, eh? User dependent. Ayo, all are user dependent only. One is simple means second one automatically complicated. Sorry, second one is what is the second one? One is simple assertion. Second one is a very simple assertion, not complicated. Yes or no? First one is simple. Second one is very simple assertion. So nothing but it is called as a, yes, very simple only, but technically we can use augmented version. Augmented version, two are available there. So now, to handle our assertions, to handle assertion, sir, what is the keyword? Assert is the keyword. It is not coming. There are two types of assertions, simple and augmented. No, done. The next step. Sir, assert is the one keyword available there. Syntax. Sir, what is the keywords are asset? Asset is the keyword. Condition. that you can give your expression. What about augmented version? I will give examples, don't bother about it. Augmented version. So at this time, same asset only. Asset only we can give keyword, we can give condition, expression, comma, message. Augmented means just like one now, message you need to pass. So both we are using as a asset only the keyword. This is the syntax, sir. Based on the syntax, you can give condition, expression, or else you can give as a message also. So observe here carefully. So the condition expression will be evaluated first. Okay. If it is true, program will be executed successfully. If it is false, the program will be terminated and it will be raising the assertion error. Just now I am telling, sir, when asset will be activated means whenever any wrong goes, then only asset will be activated. Otherwise, asset won't activate it. Program will be done normally. So, if the conditional expression will be evaluated first, and if it is a true, then the program will be continued. Assertion won't execute. If it is a false, then program will be terminated. By raising assertion error. So first, whatever your condition you are providing, it will be evaluated. If it is true, program will be continued. Otherwise, program will be terminated. It will give the assertion error. Whenever by seeing this error, programmer can analyze the code and can fix the problem. So that is syntax. Now I will write one or two programs. How it is evaluated, see. Okay. Take a Python program. Go to the new. Others Python. Sorry, yeah. Simple program. Already you know. Def square root of x. This is the one function. This is the one function. Sir, as this someone is asking difference between function and method. Sir, function means directly if I'm declaring, that is called as a function. You can call this function directly anywhere. But what about our method within the within the class, if I am declaring, then only it is called as a method. Okay. Yes, 1 second. Madam Mohan Sundari.
Sir.
Yes. Yeah, today no tested class. Monday we will continue. Now I am taking the Python class. Okay. You can you join Monday?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Sir, now. Sir, def square root. Yes, it is your own function. Sir, tomorrow I will call that function compulsory. Okay. Suppose write the code, internal code. Return x star x. Perfect. Sir, I want to print. No assertion, directly I am writing. Sir, what is the function name? Where it of 2. 3, 4. Now, see this. Now, save this in the test.py. So now observe carefully. If I run the program, py, test.py, 4, 9, 16. Yes, perfect. Sir, per suppose, if I'm routing program as a like this, by mistake I'm given double star. What happened? 427, 256. But output is wrong. I'm not getting any assertion. I'm not getting anything. Now what I was doing is, sir, here first I want to provide a simple assertion. What to do means, sir, what is the keyword? Assert is the keyword. Sir, what is the function? Square root. Square root of 2 equal to 4. So square root of 2 is 4. Again, assert. Square root of 3. equal to 9. Assert square root of 4 equal to 16. Now observe. Sir, whenever assert is the keyword, see the syntax. I'm given conditional expression. First, I'm not providing any message. Just I'm given simple assertion only. So what will happen? 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16. So I am given expected result and actual result. So this is my expectations. After execution, what is the actual result? Both it is comparing. If everything perfect goes, program will be executed. Otherwise, see assertion error you are getting. See that. Sir, 3 square 9. Sir, am I getting assertion error? Yes. Because of something goes wrong in my program. What is my expected result? 9. But what is the actual result? Will come something goes wrong. That's why assertion error came. Immediately programmer will analyze their code. Okay, what's the wrong with that code? 4, 9, 16 is my expectation, but something goes at the time of runtime. Sir, without message, if I'm writing, that is called as a simple assertion. What is augmented means? I will give one message. See the here, whatever is provided is conditional expression, comma message. So same program, just to comma, give your message. What is that message? The square of 2 is 4. The square of 3 should be 9. Just message only we are passing, nothing that comma, the square of 4 is 16. Now done. See, sir, previously just it is coming this one. Now if I am run this, what will happen? Observe carefully. Yes, with the message I am getting, sir, observe carefully. Previously, if I am not providing any messages, just assertion error came. Now what happened, sir? Assertion error, the square of 3 should be 9. Message will come or not? Message is coming. Sir, that is called as augmented version. Without message is called as a simple. Because of, what is the problem? Okay, I am given double star. For suppose, you can use single star. Your expected result, actual result same. Assert command won't execute, observe. Program will be done perfectly, 4, 9, 16. Expected actual will come, no problem. Program is executed successfully. So when assert is activated means, sir, whenever your expected result, the actual result is mismatches, then only assert will be activated. Otherwise, asset won't activate it. If you want to activate only asset, without message you can give. That is simple version. With the message you are provided, that is called as augmented version. So at the time of development testing, Selenium with the Python, assets are important. If you are a Python developer, asset command at the time of debugging time. Selenium with Java also, asset equals command is there. So because I am expecting something, but what is actual? Both are same on it. Sir, see here, if both are same, any asset is activated? No. If I am given by mistakely double star means power, we know. So expected actual wrong. So asset is activated. The square of 3 should be the 9. Okay, so something goes wrong in my program and I will be evaluated. Sir, even the asset commands are available. No. As a test engineer, compulsory, we know each and everything. We have expected results, so compulsory. Actual result, we don't know. That's why I'm getting. See, if it is a developer tester, compulsory expected actual results are available. Engineer, without you are expecting, how you have to test any application? Suppose you are a developer, you are expecting something or not? Compulsory expected actual result, both should be available. So after program execution, both are same or not, we are checking. That is the debugging only. Developer also, suppose you are a developer, I'm given one task for you. So at the time of task, you know actual result after program execution, but actual result coming or not, we are checking. Because of without your actual result also, how you can develop any application? I'm given one task for you, bank application, okay? You are implementing something operation. So compulsory, you have clear idea what is expectation, what is actual. If it is perfect, application is perfect. If something goes on, yes, with the help of asset, you are debugging. Sir, mainly at the time of debugging only, this is important. While not writing program, never use asset command, sir. At the time of writing programs, sir, where I can use asset means no. At the time of writing program, we never use this asset. Whenever test engineer intimated one defect to the developer, your responsibility is you have to resolve that bug, then debugging is required line by line. Then only you can use asset commands. Otherwise, no need to use these assets. That is, I am telling, assets are mainly used at the time of debugging concept only. While writing programs are where can use means, we never use these assets, only debugging time only. Now, sir, already asset command is there. If something goes wrong, asset is activated, but I don't want to activate asset, sir. I want to run program as it is. So 2 **2, 3 *, asset don't act, sir. Sir, if I'm running directly, asset is activated, assertion error came. How to disable assertion even though program is available? Simple thing, py. Sir, hyphen capital O, 1 second, capital O, one test.py. Even the asset command is there, it will be disabled. Direct your program will be executed, 427.256. So like that, how to disable your assertion by running that one. This is sample program and note to disable asset statements, mechanism py already test.py. Sir, for the test sessions, more explanation not required, sir. Whenever you are getting errors, debugging time only, instead of print statements, these are very, very useful. Sir, anyone tell what is the difference between exception handling and assertions? Both are same. Exception handling versus assertion. Please tell. Already exception handling we completed. Assertion just now I explained. What it is, both are same, huh? No. Sir, what is the assertion concept? Sir, assertion concept can be used in exception handling program terminated gracefully. Okay. Sir, at the time of exception handling can be used to handle the runtime errors. But what is assertion concept? It is used to alert the programmer to resolve development time errors. Observe carefully. Assertion concept can be used to alert the programmer to resolve development time errors. But what is exception handling? Can be used to handle runtime error. That is exception handling versus assertion. So assertion is just we are alerted to the programmer at the time of development any errors are there, then accept is. Exception handling means runtime errors. Then I can go for the exception handling concept. So that is a small topic only about the assertions. While debugging, if your code is not properly running, wherever mistakes is there to identify, just you can use this asset concept. Two types are there, simple and augmented. A small shorter topic only, we end up nothing in these assertions. Developers, testers, very, very important. If your program is not working, then go for this assertion topic.